Adaptations in toucan. This is a bird that is seen in tropical rainforest. Usually, tropical rainforests have very good rainfall. This we have already discussed. Apart from that, they have very good plants and flora and fauna also very rich. So different types of plants are available, different types of animals are also there. So there will be a high competition for food. Okay? There is a high competition for food in these animals. To avoid that, each organism will inhabit one layer. I said you stratification is there. Herbs are very short plants that are found. After that, shrubs. After that, somewhat tall trees. And then top foliage of that plants. So all the animals find themselves comfortable in some layer. All animals will not feed from one layer. So one animal that feeds on the topmost layer is toucan. Okay? It has colorful feathers and very big beak. Like this, its beak is very big. Bigger than its face. So you can see it is like this. This beak, these feathers are very colorful. Colorful feathers. And long beak. Long beak. You can see, compared to face, its beak is very long. It is usually found on the top of trees. Top of trees. It eats fruits. Fruits from the top. Or from the uppermost layer, whatever fruits are available. It eats and it stays also in trees. Stays in holes of big trees. Holes of big trees. Big trees usually have some holes in their bark, in their trunk, so that it makes as a home and it lives inside that. Okay, so let us see what are the adaptations that are found in this. Okay, these I'll not rub. Okay, let us rub. First advantage is, it has colorful beak, sorry, colorful feathers. Colorful feathers can change their color. So it changes color according to surroundings. Changes color. So if it is in green leaves, it changes itself to green. If it is in red leaves, it changes itself to red. In this way, it can camouflage. So I said you, what are the two advantages of camouflaging? One is it can protect itself from the predator. And second is it can find its prey also. So it not only eats most of the fruits, sometimes it hunts the small insects to eat. So that also it is helpful. It can camouflage itself and it can hunt those small insects that are found on the trees. Right. That is the advantage of this colorful feathers. It has long beak. This long beak is not pointed. It is somewhat blunt. Because of this reason, it can pluck the flowers at the end of branches, pluck the fruits from the end of branches. Okay? It need not extend to the end of the branch to find its food. So usually ends of the branches are very tender. And they can all break very fastly if bird sits on that. So it can sit somewhere here. It can extend its body to some extent, its beak. Then it can pluck the fruit that is at the end of the branch. Okay, it will not fall. Second thing is that beak is blunt. It can carry this fruit. If it is having very thin beak, that beak will not be able to bear that heavy weight. But these fruits, it can carry because of that heavy beak that it has, which is bigger than its face, okay? So it can pluck the fruits by that heavy beak that it has. It can go to the ends of branches. It can take that fruits, and that heavy beak can hold that fruit also. It will not fall because of the heavy beak, heavy fruits. Next advantage is it eats from top layer. So their competition will be reduced to some extent. Lower layers has more competition. There may be rats, squirrels, small animals. So many animals will be there in the tropical rainforest. At the topmost region, there will be very less competition. So that is the advantage of eating from the top. Next, it has very good feet also. Feet of this toucan has 4 toes, and these toes are bent like this, with claws here. Okay, so 2 toes on the front side, 2 toes are towards the forward direction, 2 toes are towards backward direction. Because of this reason, it can hold on the branch. It is standing on this branch, 2 toes are extended forward, 2 toes on that side backward. So in that way, it can hold on the branch firmly in on which it is standing. Right? So these are the 4 adaptations that are found in toucans. Okay? They have colorful feathers that help it to camouflage itself into its surrounding. It has long blunt beak that helps it to pluck the fruits and hold the fruits, store the fruits so that it can carry towards it. And it has, it eats food on the top layer, and it has feet which has 4 toes, 2 on the forward direction, 2 on the backward direction. So these are the adaptations of toucan. Next, let us see the adaptations of monkey. Monkeys of tropical rainforest are different from the local monkeys. Almost all the features are same with a little bit of variation. Monkeys usually feed on the canopy. They feed on canopy means they are also feeding on tropical rainforest, but these are found in Western Ghats. Rainforests that are found in Western Ghats. So Western Ghats, where they are present? So I'm not sure to draw this, but This side, these are called Western Ghats. These are Eastern Ghats. Our area, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana side, we are having Eastern Ghats. But this opposite side, towards Maharashtra and other areas, we have that Western Ghats. These Western Ghats have rainforest. In the canopy of Western Ghats, these are found. Monkeys are found. It does not mean that in other areas it is not found, but especially speaking about the monkeys that are found in tropical rainforest. We can find monkeys everywhere here also. These monkeys are somewhat different. They are having somewhat brownish body, yellowish brown body. Those, tropical rainforest will have blacker face, blacker body and very long tail compared to local monkeys. So they are found extensively in this region, okay? More they are found in rainforest of Western Ghats. What is, they are having very long tail. They are usually living on trees openly. That means they do not build anything like nest, or they do not search for holes to live inside, nothing like that. They are living openly on the trees. So what are the adaptations of these animals? First one, they have long, strong tail. This long, strong tail acts as an arm to climb from one tree to another tree, to jump over the branches and all. Why? It holds, with the help of that tail, it holds some branches and jumps from one place to another place. So this long, strong tail helps it to move from one tree to another tree. It is a fast climber. Fast climber. This its body's physique is suited. You can see some animals like, did you ever see a donkey that is having flexible body enough to climb a body? A monkey's body is flexible enough to climb the body, climb the trees. So this flexible body, which is having front legs are flexible, back legs are flexible, this flexibility helps it to climb long back legs compared to front legs, helps it, makes it an efficient climber over the trees. Next. It has a very good eyesight. I said you, not all the animals have very good eyesight. All animals do not have very good eyesight. Some animals can see some colors, some animals cannot see colors, some animals cannot understand the shape of the creature that is in front. So different animals have different vision, but animals living in tropical rainforests like this monkey have very good vision. This helps them to see the branches that are ahead of it, or take the vegetables, fruits, whatever it is eating. It eats not. It eats everything, like it eats tree stems, fruits, seeds. It eats insects also. Insects also it eats. Stems also it eats. What else? So all these things are found in the tropical rainforest. Roots also it eats. So the food that is available is suitable for the place it is living. That is also an adaptation. It is living in tropical rainforest, and all these food is available in the tropical rainforest. That is one of the adaptation of monkey for the survival. So these are the adaptations. Long tails. Long tails help it to climb from one tree to another tree. Fastest climber, flexible body, it helps it to climb the trees very fast. Very good eyesight helps it to identify what is in front of it, what is any predator comes to hunt it also. It runs very fast. And it eats trees, stems, fruits, insects, roots, which all are available inside the tropical rainforest. Another type of monkey is there that we'll discuss now. Its name is lion-tailed macaque. Yeah, monkeys come very rarely down to the trees. Most of the time they spend on the trees only. If it has to drink water, definitely they have to come down to the ground. Lion-tailed macaque. This is an animal which is similar to monkey only. It is a type of monkey only, but difference is around its face, the hair is projected long like this. So it is also called as beard ape. And its body has tail. This tail has tuft of hair at the end, like a lion has. That is one more difference, right? So remaining things all are same, but this hair is present around the face like a lion, and at the end of tail there is a tuft of hair. Those two are different. Remaining things, it has hands and legs like any other. No difference in all these structures, right? So what are the adaptations of this animal? So it also spends most of the time on trees. Openly, it lives on the trees. All the adaptations of a monkey, normal monkey, it has. Like it has very good eyesight, tail to hold over the trees. It eats fruits, vegetables, stems, leaves. It removes the bark. See, trees bark have, if you remove the bark of tree, you'll find some insects. Those insects it will eat. insects that are found below the bark. It will scratch the bark, it will remove the bark, and it will eat the insects that are present below the bark. Okay, what are the adaptations? Other adaptations, it is also a good climber. It is also having very strong tail. All the adaptations are similar, only it is having structural difference, that is, it looks like a lion, and it is called as beard tail. So that is about the animals' adaptations in tropical rainforest, children.